person in the world right now?
Look at how bad I'm shaking.
What would you think to me?
Like, this is wild.
Oh my god,
you're in my personal space.
Look
again.
What you left me with. This is not how I walked in. This is not what I have been paying a service for as I continually come here as a repeat customer.
If you elbow me, I'm gonna lose it. I'm gonna lose it. The cops will see this. The cops, everybody's gonna see it.
No one's obligated to do it.
You should have just sat down and got your nails done and not complained. You're making the scene.
I did complain. He started with her. And you will get fired.
Oh, I'm the owner. How come I get fired?
Oh, we're all such a. It's hilarious. It's funny.
I'll take you.
The court's right down the road. He probably has more money than you two. I don't know. You're just probably going to your son in jail for his canteen.
Well, that is about the happiest ending we've gotten almost immediately to one of those. You have a woman in a Boston nail salon freaking out over her nails, which I get. Maybe you don't like your service or whatever, but getting in the face of the person, nearly elbowing another customer, threatening to get someone fired and then sue them because you didn't like how your nails came out. Like, there needs to be some karma for that. And if a nail salon full of people laughing at her is all that we can get, I guess, Kyla, I'll take it. What do you think?
That was the best part of the video. Everybody collectively laughing at her. I think the second best part that in the video would have been someone saying, "Get out of here," in the Boston accent. It would have happened, but you can't be too lucky all the time. But she definitely got what she deserved. Hope they laughed her ass all the way down the block. Oops, sorry, my language. But yeah.
No, you can say that. You're fine.
Definitely, she was definitely doing way too much. And I hope karma continues to bite her in the butt.
Exactly. Yeah. Just look, we all have experiences and businesses that we don't necessarily like, but we have to bear in mind the people working there, whether they turn out to secretly be the owner or not, like, they're working and they have their whole own thing going on. These jobs are tough. Just extend a little bit of understanding to people working, especially in the service industry. This has been a very difficult couple of years. The last thing they need is to deal with your freakouts, your swearing and getting in people's face, and like, not everything needs to escalate into, "I'm gonna try to take down your business," okay? And maybe if that's the reply that those people get in real time, maybe it'll become a little bit more rare. Maybe we can extend a little bit of understanding to these workers who are having to deal with stuff like that. Not all of them, of course, get filmed. And so I'm glad that in that case, Peaches and Screams, I think was the name of the TikToker there, being very restrained in a response, considering how close the woman is getting. Thank you for showcasing that.
No, most definitely. And again, I hope that whenever that woman goes back into another nail salon, they continue to laugh at her.
I think she's probably going to go to a different one next time, and hopefully she's going to keep it a bit more together. We'll see.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.